Hello everyone, I am Shomu Chattopadhyay and today I will present the paper named Fine-Tuning the ISO-IEC Standard LightMAC. This paper was co-authored with Oshin Jha and Mridul Nandi. We submitted this paper to AsiaCrypt 2021 and it has been published. It has been accepted, yet to be published. Okay, so first, we start with a short introduction to LightMAC. First of all, LightMAC is a parallelizable construction and it is a block cipher based message authentication code also. It was first introduced by Louis Xet and others in 2016. And it was in 2019, it was announced as one of the ISO-IEC standard lightweight MACs. The standardization number is given here. The most important features of this construction are the following. It uses two independent block cipher keys and it is based on a counter-based encoding. Let us look at this pictorial overview of LightMAC. We see that there are two kinds of inputs. These inputs are called initial inputs and this is the final input. For the initial inputs are fed into a block cipher which is instantiated by the key K, and the final one is block cipher is instantiated by key K prime. The initial inputs are the message are first we pair the messages and then we take n minus s bit block, and each block is concatenated with a binary encoding, and then they are fed into the initial block ciphers EK. Then we collect all the outputs, XOR them, and the final message block is then now XORed with the XOR of the initial outputs, and the final input is fed into the EK prime. For single key LightMAC, the last one is not EK prime. The last one is final block cipher is just same as the initial block cipher. It is just EK. And the L is the number of blocks present in the padded message M. Okay. Now, the main advantages of the LightMAC construction, that it is very simple. Its construction is very simple and it requires lower amount of memory to be stored. So it has a low overhead also. And it is also flexible kind of construction. We can have lightweight implementation as well as high computing implementation can also be done using the parallel structure. Okay. Now, let us revisit the schema of the proof of LightMAC. If we see the construction of the LightMAC, we can see it as this part. We see that this is a hash part and this is the PRP part. We name it as light hash, and this light hash is only dependent on the key K, this key. So this construction can be seen as hash then PRP construction. And if we write it in functional expression, then this is the functional expression of LightMAC depending on the key K and K prime. The proof of the original LightMAC used the hash then PRP structure, and it guaranteed that the fresh inputs always give random outputs since the keys are independent. But for single key lightmap, that is 1K lightmap, we cannot exploit the above fact because these keys are not independent now. They are the same key. So we have to try a different way to get the result. Our contributions in the paper, in this paper, are twofold. First of all, we show a security bound of order Q square by 2 over n, 2 to the power n, for 1k lightmap, for certain range of the value of L. And secondly, we propose a variant of single key lightmap, which we denote as lightmap DS. DS means domain separation here. And we also show that this achieves the security bound of Bardet bound order for some range of L. So we, in both cases, we have got rid of the L term in the security bound, and we get a Bardet bound order. Okay. If we compare these two results with the existing results of these kinds of constructions, that is PMAC type constructions, this table represents a comparative summary. These two entries which are colored red here, these entries are our contributions. So we see that it is certainly achievement, betterment of the existing results. For example, if we consider the number of block cipher keys, it is both of them are single keyed, and both of the, if we consider the PRF bound, both of them are L free bounds for certain range of L. Okay, so this table shows us our contributions in a comparative way. This is the inside view of the 1K lightmap. What does it show? If we take any arbitrary initial input xij, first we are defining it, we are showing it for a message mi. Okay, so for a message mi, any xij is fed into this block cipher, and we get yij, and these all yijs are resolved together with the last block of the padded message, and we get yizor. Yizor is the final input of the of this computation, and at last we get ti. Ti is the ith tag. Okay, so this represents the input output tuples for a message MI. Okay, so what are the bottlenecks for proving the security bounds of 1K lightmap? So these kinds of collision, this picture shows two kinds of collisions which are very important to understand the proof, the idea behind the proof. First of all, the first picture, this picture represents a collision where an initial input of a message is collided with a final input of another message, and it is we have denoted it using the red color circle. And similarly, this picture represents a kind of collision where an internal output of a message is collided with an final output of another message. This kind of collision is denoted by blue circle. This kind of, the first kind of collision is called I call, and that is input call collision, And the second kind of collision is called OCall, that is output call. Now, we see that for LightMac, the original LightMac construction, there were no issues with iCall and OCall because the final block cipher was always different from the initial block cipher. So whatever may be the initial, whatever may be the status of the iCall, it doesn't have any impact on the status of the OCall. That is, it may have that for some IA entry here, this IA colliding with some J. That is, this IA, it may happen that the iCall happens for some IAJ tuple, but OCall does not happen for IAJ tuple, and vice versa. But in case of 1K LightMac, this never happens because this final block cipher is always same as the initial block cipher. So if iCall happens, then OCall must happen. So how to get rid of, how to handle this kind of collision? One straightforward approach is just to avoid this kind of collision, iCall and OCall. But we get Q square L many terms in this way, in the numerator. How? Because the internal input have QL many choices for internal inputs and Q many choices for final input. So there are Q square L many choices for this kind of collisions. So here we get a term which is not free of L, Q square L many terms. Okay, but the denominator is always 2 to the power N. So we cannot get rid of this L term. So this straightforward approach does not work. So we have to think in a different way. So how we think, we will show in the later slides. Okay. For the general proof environment, for the proof of in case of 1K LightMac, we will use the famous H coefficient technique. And let us recall that it requires four steps. First of all, we need to define a set of transcripts. Then we have to define what is bad transcript, what is good transcript. Then we have to do good transcript analysis. And another part is remained, it is called bad transcript analysis. Altogether, this comprises the whole proof technique. But we'll see what special kind of thing we do for proving 1K, the security bound of 1K LightMac. Okay. For good transcript analysis, we choose our bad events in such a way that we get permutation comparability between the tuples of all inputs and the tuple of all outputs for a good transcript. That is, the tuple of all inputs mean the all inputs mean all initial and final inputs. So permutation comparability between two tuple means there is a permutation which when applied in on the first tuple, it gives the second tuple. So for this input tuple and output tuple, we get permutation compatibility here by choice of our bad events. In case of bad transcript analysis, we employ a novel technique, which we will see later. It's called the reset sampling, due to which we get bounds of Q score by 2 to the power n order for any bad event. What is the reset sampling strategy? It is just we do not sample, we do not restrict our sampling for the first in one stage. We first of all, for any given tuple of messages, we first sample T, that is the tags, from the space of n bit strings, and Z values also. What is Z values? Z values is sampled imitating the initial outputs of the real constructions, real construction. So if some two values of the initial input are same, then their output is also, then the Z value corresponding to them also sampled as same. Or if they are different, then two different values are sampled for Z. That is, it is kind of lazy sampling on the set of all initial inputs. So we don't impose any condition for this sampling, except that it is a without replacement sampling. Now, the second step is crucial. It is called the reset step. And what we do here, we identify all the tuple i, a, j. These tuples are called full collision tuple. What is a full collision tuple? This is nothing but the I call. If for some IA here, this collides with some J, for the simplicity of notation, I am saying IA and J just. If for some IA, this collides with some J here, then IAJ is called full collision tuple. And for any full collision tuple, we reset the Z values, as we will see in the next slide. This is the resetting technique. If the collision happens, it means XIA is equal ZJ ZOR. Then YIA is sampled as TJ. TJ is already sampled, so we just write YIA equals TJ. And for all other Y, for all other IA, which are not full collision tuple, we just rename the Z to be Y. Okay, so this is the reset technique. This is the reset sampling or the resetting technique. So what was the intuition behind the approach? The basic intuition behind the approach that we might get some joint events bad events. We might get some joint kind of events, which will help us to get 2 to the power 2n in the denominator of the bounds. Okay, so whatever L terms may be in the numerator, we can get rid of them, exploiting the extra 2 to the power n factor in the denominator. So that was the basic intuition behind the reset sampling. As an example, let us consider one bad event in the proof. This event is called bad Y1. Bad Y1, what is bad Y1? Here we see that XIA is ZJ ZOR, that is IAJ is a full collision, and for the final input of I, is also collided with the initial input of some message. Okay, so this joint event is a bad event, which if we if we compute its probability, we get Q cube L squared terms in the numerator and 2 to the power 2n in the denominator. So that this ratio Q cube L squared by 2 to the power 2n is L free for a suitable range of L, the L that we see in the final result, Okay, so this is the, this kind of thing happens for all other bad events also. Okay. So this is the final result of 1K Lightmap. We get here that this bound is of the Q square 2 to the power 2 to the power n order for this range of L. Okay, and this bound is actually L free for this range of L. So this is the final result for 1K LiteMac. And here we are done with the first part of our paper. The next part deals with this construction, LiteMac DS. DS means domain separation. Here, the initial inputs are made such that always it begins with a zero. The most significant bit of any initial input here is zero. And for the final input, we use this fix one function. It makes the final input the most significant bit of the final input forcefully to one. What fix one does? Fix one forcefully sets the MSB of the final input to be one. So we see that what is the advantage of this construction? No initial input can collide with a final input because the MSB of any initial input is zero, whereas the MSB of any final input is always one. So no way to handle I call indices. Recess sampling is also not required here because there is no full collision tuple as such here. And so this has an easier proof than the 1K LiteMac, and it is given in a detailed way in our paper. And this is the final advantage that we get for LiteMac DS. And this is the range of L. So with this, we conclude the second part of the paper also. And we thank everyone for listening to the presentation. And thank you very much. Okay.